Everybody loves the story of the very hungry caterpillar. But a new study shows that pooping caterpillars have a story to tell too. I'm Dan Riskin. If you live in Canada, chances are you have experience with caterpillar outbreaks. Every 5 years or so, forests are suddenly blanketed with caterpillars, mostly tent caterpillars or an invasive species called Limantria dispar, or LD moths. This past year was especially bad for those in central and eastern Canada. Well, a new study shows that those caterpillars aren't just bad for the trees, they affect nearby lakes too. In a normal year, trees put nitrogen out into their leaves for summer so they can photosynthesize at full steam, but then when autumn comes, before the leaves fall, that nitrogen gets sucked back up into the tree so it won't get wasted. As a result, fall leaves don't have a lot of nitrogen in them. But when those very hungry caterpillars eat those leaves in the summer, the nitrogen goes right through them and falls to the forest floor as poop. Now, we know from agriculture that when farmers put too much nitrogen fertilizer on their fields, it can end up in the water and it upsets the chemical balance of lakes and streams. So researchers wondered if caterpillars might be doing the same thing. So they took 32 years of data on lake chemistry from all over Ontario, and then they superimposed 32 years of caterpillar outbreak data from the same regions. And lo and behold, they saw that caterpillar outbreaks were associated with spiked nitrogen concentrations in lakes, more than doubling the nitrogen levels compared to non-outbreak years. It's a connection no one had considered before, but it's worth pointing out there is some good news here. Once the population explosion ends and things go back to normal the following year, so does the chemistry of the lakes. It's a nice reminder of the resilience of nature. For CTVnews.ca, I'm Dan Riskin.